Introduction to the delta-wye transformer connection, part 6A. In this part, we'll talk about the voltage phasor diagram for the delta transformer connection. So basically, we're going to understand how this particular transformer diagram that's often found in like nameplates, for example, we'll find out exactly how this is drawn and what this represents. If you haven't already, go ahead and click on the button on the bottom right side of your screen and click on subscribe. You want to subscribe and then get notified exactly when the next part of this video is going to come out. Okay, so let's scroll down and then look at what we've done in the past. So in part 2 of this video, which you'll find a link right here, In part 2, we talked about the line-to-line voltage versus phase voltage relationship for both the delta connection as well as the Y or star connection. Okay, now make sure you review the part 2 if you're having a hard time recalling. When we measure the line-to-line voltage between line A and line B, we'll see that that is essentially equal to phase A voltage. Similarly, when we measure the line-to-line voltage between line B and line C, it's going to equal phase B voltage. And lastly, when we measure between line C and line A, that's going to equal phase C voltage. Again, this was covered in-depthly in part 2. So in this video, we're going to further talk about these voltage quantities on the delta side. Okay. Now to begin, let's clarify something. Okay, so the delta has no ground, right? But there is a ground somewhere in our source. Some generator in this source is tied to the ground. And that ground is the reference for this transformer, right? So we're going to assume that it's this particular connection. So we know what the ground is. So we know that this ground is for this source, and this ground is in reference to this particular delta connection. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to connect this ground, I'm going to tie that ground to the Y side. Okay, and I'm going to say it's all the same ground, right? Now that I've have that established, okay, I have the same reference quantity established, what I'm going to say is that the voltage across line A and this ground point here. So if I measure the voltage across line A and this ground point here, I'm going to call that voltage VAG. Okay, I've drawn the arrows here to indicate that. Now VBG, that's going to be measured across line B and ground. So we're going to add arrows to illustrate that here. Okay, so there's VBG. Now I'm going to make this a little bit better. And lastly, VCG is a voltage across line C and ground. Now the trick to understanding voltage phasors for the delta connection is really rooted in the understanding of VAG versus VAB, okay? So VAB is a voltage across line A and line B, which is essentially equal to phase A voltage. So we're talking about the difference of understanding phase A voltage versus VA to ground voltage, okay? And oftentimes this VA to G quantity is also called VAN and is also referred to as this reference quantity, okay? This reference quantity. And again, if you like this video, and if you want to see when part 6B is going to come out, click on the button on the bottom right corner of the screen and then click subscribe. Once you've subscribed, you'll get an update in part 6B as well as other video tutorials. This video was brought to you by GeneralPAC.com, making power system protection, automation, and controls intuitive.